Good morning students, I hope you are well and fit at home. So already we discussed about the, in the previous class we discussed about the what are the how to conduct the experiments. So apart from conducting experiments, what other skills we need to become a good scientist? So that is reading skills. Now we discuss about the reading skills. So before reading, what you have to do? So before reading, you have to go through the content or topic and what are the new words which you don't know. So those words first you have to note down. For example, in your book they have given regarding endemic species. So they have given, you see here a page, this one you observe. So this is there in your sixth lesson. It is there in the sixth lesson, but here for your understanding, I will explain endemic. Already we discussed, and this is a new word for you. You don't know what is endemic and what is ecology. So this type of words, first you have to, what you have to do, you have to find out the meaning. What does it mean? Then the next, what you have to do during reading. So what you have to do during the reading, you have to do, you have to collect the details of particular topic. So what is there in the topic, what is the gist, what is the theme, you have to understand. So if you did not understand, read again and again unless you understand, and you refer the other books also to find out the matter, to get that particular matter. Then after reading, so what you have to do after reading? So after reading, summarize what you have read. So what you have gone through, that one you have to summarize. So you will get an idea after reading, you will have an idea. So then think about what you have already learned about that particular topic. So here I have written about the ecosystem, ecology. So it may be, take the pond as an ecosystem, a tree as an ecosystem, your home as a ecosystem. Anyone in any topic you take, you should get a proper grip, thoroughness on that particular topic. So this is about the reading skills. Now we'll discuss about the what are the how to write to communicate. So what, whatever you read, that one you have to present. How you will present? Through the writing. Through the writing you can present. So it will be helpful. You may forget in the after a few days. So if you keep in the writing form, it will be useful for you. So not only for you, for the other people, it will be useful. That's a scientist. What they will do, they will write whatever ideas, innovative ideas, whatever they want to do, they will put it on a paper and then preserve. They will for the next generations. See, the same way, what you have to do, you have whatever new ideas or whatever you want to do, that one you have to represent in the form of writing. So writing to communicate, then writing to communicate. So for proper communication, writing is very much important. So scientists write about what they learn in their research and investigation to help others understand the work they have done. What they have done to help others for the further research, they have to write, they have to record that in the form of writing. So if you see the writings are that, this writing mode is also different. The first one, informative writing. First one, informative. Informative writing. See, the answer is there in the information, a form of statement, a form of statement, a form of information. So that is called as the informative writing. Describe your observations, inferences, and conclusions. is you are giving a type of information to the others by conducting the experiments. So this is called as informative writing. The second one is narrative writing in the form of narrative. This is called narrative writing, means the explaining, narrate a story. Okay, so here describe something, give examples or tell a story. So the narrative writing by giving different type of examples. For example, see the previous classes for conducting experiments, we conducted different experiments for taking soil one time, by taking shells, by taking the type of different types of clothes. So these are all why you are taking these many examples to make you understand better. So that is called as narrative writing. The narrative writing, we have to describe something by giving examples, with the help of the stories. So that is called as narrative writing. Then expressive writing. Another one is expressive. So what is expressive writing? Write letters, poems or songs which express others. That is called as the expressive writing. So another one is persuasive writing. So here write letters about important issues in the science. What are the issues? What issues you face? That one you have to mention in the persuasive writing. So apart from this, scientists, they used the different types of measurements, like that they have to measure the length, breadth, the height, or they may measure the mass or weight with the help of the measurements. And also using numbers, scientists, they use the numbers 1, 2, 3, like the decimals. These all they will use for conducting the experiments and to communicate, they will use these numbers and to interpret the data. And also by interpreting the data, they interpret, they show the data with the help of the graphs. They use the graphs as well as pie diagrams. You see, this is the graphical representation. This is the graphical representation. By using the pie diagrams, they can interpret the data. Means they will conclude the experiments. Now we'll discuss. So this is about yours. What are methods the scientists follow? So now we'll discuss what type of care should be taken. Safety measures. When you enter into the lab, science lab, so what care should be taken by a student? First, before entering into the lab, we have to carry all the things which are needed for that particular experiment. So you should have a idea, proper idea and a proper written form of the experiment. That is the first point. Think ahead. The first one is think. The second one, be aware. So keep your lab, the particular area where you are conducting the experiment, that one you have to keep neat and clean. And third one, you should not throw the things here and there, because that is the lab, you have to keep it neat and clean. So that's why you should not throw the things here and there. So if you want to throw or break or cut something, you have to inform your teacher. You have to inform your teacher. Then you have to do the things. Why? Because all the chemicals will be there and all glass items will be there. So care should be taken. Then watch your eyes. So when you deal with the chemicals, you have to wear the goggles. You have to use the goggles, and your long hairs will be there. You have to tie up the hairs and also the sleeves. Sleeves, you have to use the apron to keep yourself protected. Then so never drink or eat anything in the science lab. You should not drink or eat anything in the science lab. And then one, protect yourself from shocks. So in the physics, you can deal with the electricity, the current. So the term care should be taken by using the plugs and wires. Then keep it clean. Keep your lab area clean. After finishing the experiment, just clean that particular part and you keep all the items in their particular places and leave the science lab. So these are the measures you have to, safety measures you have to follow while entering into the lab, while conducting the experiments. Okay, then, so why we are discussing all these things? Why? Because necessity is the mother of invention. Necessity is the mother of invention. For example, you see, in the olden days, when the transportation is not there, the people use it to walk from one place to another place. Or if the distance is more, they use the bullock carts. Afterwards, slowly, they invent the bicycle. So to move faster, they invent the bikes, then cars. Then now they are using the aeroplanes, jets, etc. So this is nothing but our necessity. This is the necessity. So the necessity is the mother of invention. So who knows? Among you, some people, you may become the future scientists. So that's why follow all these measures and try to understand the lesson. If you have any doubts, I will clarify the doubts in the June class. Thank you.